Hello, this is FreezeVet and here we are with another build video. This is a small house, smallish house. I think I've built houses like this before. There are somewhere on this channel. We are gonna try this. This is kind of a modern studio apartment kind of thing. Which I definitely have built in the past and probably looks a bit like it as well. But we are gonna at least try to make it through this voiceover. It's currently summer here. That would, if you think summer, you would think heat, sunshine, but it's all cloudy and stuff and not that warm. So that's great. That's gonna be my summer for this year. Well, I haven't been on vacation, like a real summer vacation, for years. I can't really tell you the last time I really went somewhere in the summer for vacation. I do have some 2 weeks off of my work in September, but we shall see what weather that brings, because if it's not already great weather, what would the future hold? Who knows? But yeah, I also, it's Thursday, and in a week from now I'm gonna upload this video. I also today watched the season, the episode of The Handmaid's Tale, episode 9, Heroic, it was called. And I'm gonna do my best to talk about it while we're watching this lovely build happen. So let me sit myself down, literally shift myself on the chair, shift the cushion. The cushion. It's great. It's gonna be a great voiceover. I can already tell. So, last episode 8, the one before 9, of course. It ended with June attacking off Matthew. No, that was the episode before that. This episode 8 ended with Off Matthew in the grocery store. Oats and fishes, something like that. With a gun in her hand, pointed it at Aunt Lydia, and then she gets shot. Great scene. This episode starts with June in a hospital room on her knees. That already sounds bad, but we're gonna make it a tiny bit worse. So why not? Just because we can. The whole episode was almost completely shot in this hospital room. June was forced to sit there until the baby came. Yeah, this is a great regime. They're very very religious, definitely. Yep, it's just great. Great in every sense of the word. So let's start with what I thought of the episode. Before I make a complete fool of myself. So the whole thing was, as I just said, filmed almost in this hospital room, with June sitting at the end of Matthew's, Natalie's. She has a name, of course. They all have names. They just are not really used. With Matthew's in a hospital bed, completely wired to machines, we quickly find out that Natalie is probably brain dead, and they're legit just keeping her alive in sake of the baby, because that's what Gilead wants. It wants to repopulate with kids that obey and are true for. I don't really know what they really want. Doubt they don't even know it themselves. But yeah, we just started off there. It's a great starting point. June is being forced to sit there and wait until the baby comes. She is forced to sit on her knees. Apparently, when I thought that they were completely nuts, eventually she ended up in a bed at night. So she kind of had a little bit of time for her knees to not be sat on, because that's definitely hard. And we could also slowly see June losing herself, losing her mind. That's just already great. Yeah, as we all thought, as I kind of read and watch commentary on The Handmaid's Tale, I think we all thought that June was getting away with a lot. But this episode kind of felt like she was being punished, kind of a bit, not being let home, not being able to go home. Watching as her walking partner is being kept alive by machines in hopes of a new baby in this world. I also thought that the doctor that was looking after of Matthew was kind of creepy. He's kind of a weird dude. Just kind of. But when he was stitching her hand up, I don't know why June thought she was gonna be able to do anything to Serena. I don't really know why she thought she could kill her or whatever. But the doctor suddenly seemed kind of nice. And it's strange because I don't think doctors are allowed. The men were not really allowed to talk to these handmaids. June is not allowed to talk to men at all, I think, unless she is being talked to. But all of a sudden he kind of looked nice, as that there was legit no reason for helping June. June is not really somebody that's very comes across as very nice. That so you why would you help her? But then I all of a sudden thought maybe he's gonna be help in the future for her too. She wants to save all the kids in Gilead. I don't know where she gets this from. Just because she saved one kid, she thinks she can save everybody. But maybe this doctor is gonna be an ally for her. She's gonna need a lot of people to save all those kids. I watch Grey's Anatomy, which is a doctor's TV show. And when people die there, the brain, the heart monitor goes crazy. And with Natalie, I thought we were gonna see her die, but now I'm not quite sure if she really died, as her heart meter monitor thingy just went a tiny bit quicker, but not making it sound like she was dying or she was dead. But if she was really brain dead, then that can technically means that she's dead and there's no way of recovering her. She's just dead and she won't be saved. That's apparently really what happens. And then there was that scene with Janine. And Janine said, Janine just came in there to talk to June, just because she could, just to be nice. And then eventually she says to June, "You've changed that, don't like it." That's just really real. I think we've all seen June change ever since now that Hannah's gone. She is definitely indifferent, and don't know, so far I don't think it's for the better, but we shall see what happens. Then that the other Janine moment this episode was when she was sat on the ground praying for of Matthew, and she had her hair in front of her eye because her eye was looking yucky. And Lydia says that she should put her hair back and that vanity is not good for you. And then at the end, and Lydia gives Janine like a thing pirates wear in front of their missing eye. And that it's sometimes hard to read Aunt Lydia, I think, because she kind of looks like she cares about these handmaids, but then I also don't think she cares enough, because if she really cared, she would help get them out or make their lives better or something. I also kind of thought that Natalie might have of Matthew might have been right, that the baby in her that she was that was in her belly was a girl. She thought that, but apparently this was also a guy. Not that that really matters, but still, a guy or a girl, there's no future for a kid in Gilead. That's just a messed up society, so there's just nothing. And then of course I also watched the preview for next week's episode, and that looked promising, but also the preview for this episode looked promising as well. And it just was not, it was kind of heavy, the episode, but every episode is heavy. But also, it still is so slow. I would expect them to be fighting Gilead, like really hands on by now. And they really aren't, not close or something, close to making it stop. So we have to see online. I said we only have 4 episodes left. 4 episodes doesn't sound like enough to make this end well. So I think we're scheduled for next season. I really don't really know how June is gonna save all those kids, to be quite honest with you. No clue. I don't even think she knows how she's gonna save them, so that's gonna be great. But I think that's kind of the wrap around of this episode, which is gonna be, of course, not as thorough as you might want, we're currently just gonna end this voiceover. We're talking about the build, I think. Although I rather talk about something like that, like the TV show The Handmaid's, because that's easier to talk about. And I might have gone for a little, as I said, modern, but this might not be very modern looking back at it. This house build, we're back on the house build commentary, putting some commentary on what I've built. And of course, as always, the screenshots are at the end of the video. This is just a one-parter, which is also nice, I think. I really wanted to fit in this this table with the 4 places to sit, but it's also kind of difficult. This is more like a kind of retro house, I think. The colors at least look a bit like that. And of course, we're dragging the color choice that I made out really far, just to hope that it will, how would you say that, wrap the whole build together, make it very cohesive, if that's an option. I do think something like that could help bring the whole build together. Now we're trying to pick a rock, but it's a very small space, so it's harder to find a rock that fits. I think the 4 square wide rock was a good option. This is just a bit bigger, but could also work. And I like when there is more option to sit in a house. That in case this Sim has friends over, he could pull up a couple of other chairs and just have some extra seating. But this poof ottoman thingy could also be used just to pull up against the couch. Lay your feet on. I have one of those myself. Very useful. Oh, we're not using that one. Don't think I... Oh, this one might be a tiny bit smaller. Could be. Not quite sure. And of course we need a plant in there. I always try to put a plant in every room of the houses I build. And I kind of have that here in my own house. Kind of. I don't have a plant in my bathroom or in my half bath. But I think I can get away with that. I have thought about it, but there's just not really any room for it to really be put down. I also today did some yard work. I have this quite nice garden, quite big spacious garden, but the weeds in there just get crazy, and I had to take out weeds again today. But it's also kind of good because tomorrow they are gonna collect the garbage out of my container, which could be good if we make that work. I like it to be kind of full. I'm just me on my own, so I don't have that much garbage to be collected, but I still like to make an effort, especially with the yard stuff. I don't particularly really enjoy taking weeds out of my garden, but I do kind of enjoy it when it's done, when it looks all nice and pretty. So I try to do it every other week, kind of. That also helps if you make it any longer, it probably will become a lot, and I don't want to spend my whole day taking care of things like that. But I think we're almost done. We're gonna in a second jump into another little part of the building, as when I was looking through my files to see which build would be next, I saw I didn't finish this build, so I went back and finished it. Because by now the build just looks a bit empty. It's just the house plopped on a spot of land, and I would like a little bit of landscaping. That's definitely what we're gonna do right now. And then once I've done this, I don't think I have anything else left to do for the rest of the day. Which just, that sounds lovely, doesn't it? Just nothing to do for the rest of the day. So I'm thinking about what I could do. I am probably gonna start my Sims game up in a second, because why not? And of course this house really needed a hot tub in there. I often halfway through the week think, oh, I haven't started up my game. I can tell you what is to blame for that. Me and my Love Island addiction. We're not gonna talk about it. No, we're not. It's not gonna happen. But yeah, as I said, we're just finishing off the garden. I like to put some kind of sitting arrangement and a barbecue in there. Don't own a barbecue, and I don't think I really will buy one. I have no clue how to light a barbecue. Probably way too scared of it to really make an effort on learning. So I probably won't buy one, but I do kind of enjoy eating barbecue food. That's probably also the reason why I put a barbecue in almost every house I built. Oh, I decided to do this fun thing here, right? With this wall. Doesn't really make any sense, but it doesn't really matter. It's just there, and it gives a bit extra to the build. And I like sometimes to make it look like I put a little bit of effort in. And I've never used bamboo in my build, so we're doing that right now kind of fits the modern-esque vibe. This is thing that The Sims 3 does, they give you a couple of resizes of trees. So I had to place down a couple of extra to get enough trees to fill my lineup. And then of course you twist them around a bit to make it look like it's not all the same. And we do that with the front as well. Because there is a lot of, that's a great sentence. There are a lot of windows, big windows that could lead to people seeing inside your house. And you might really not be into that. So we're placing down these nice bamboo trees to block the view a bit. But that's also the end of this build for me and my voiceover. If you enjoyed watching this video, you should really like it. Subscribe to my channel so you see the next build in 2 weeks time. My name is Friesenven and I hope you enjoyed watching this. And yes, well, have a nice day. Bye.